So, as I said, I work in both marketing research and UX. I kind of work in both those worlds, so this was something I was passionate about. But as these two things have evolved, as companies have evolved, they've kind of kept them in separate silos. And depending on your company, it might look different than this, but ultimately the goal is to create customer experience as a core competency within the organization. And what happens with this kind of setup is that just isn't happening for a lot of people. So why is that happening? So let's talk about the assumption that basically marketing research and UX are different. We know they do different things, but it really goes a lot deeper. In the next few slides, I want to show you how we're different, and you could agree or disagree. As we know, UX people on the left, they're left brain. They poke their stick at users, and they're very practical. Market researchers are right brained, as we know, and they're concerned with emotional responses, although sometimes they're not really up on what happens with an interface. They also have different goals when approaching an interface. For UX, it's about effectiveness, efficiency, and satisfaction, kind of cold-blooded, if you think about it. Marketing research, more business-centric, translating customer needs into dollars. For UX, their training is usually in human factors, design, marketing research, more social sciences, soft sciences, statistics, and they also have unique cultures and their own nomenclature. They really don't even speak the same language. I mean, it's almost tribal. They use these artificial barriers, almost like other social tribes, like words are used as shibboleths to kind of exclude rather than include people. And Kathy Kaiser, who's on our panel, did a great presentation last year kind of covering that. And ultimately, what do they deliver? They're responsible for really two different things. UX, although it does get bogged down sometimes in clickstream and KPIs that kind of lose sight of the overall customer experience, market research can also do that as well. So what we did was we did some neuroscience in the lab and we found out, yes, UXers and marketing researchers are both left and right brain. So, by the way, the F here stands for frontal lobe, just to let you know. And not only that, we have the same tools. Look at this toolbox. Anyone who has done any kind of research in any area knows this is pretty much the tools that everybody has. You may call them something different. So the question is, why bother? Why bother getting these two groups together? Well, let me tell you, you can't get too comfortable. Just as customers are taking control of the conversation, management has put greater expectations on what an interface can do. So let's take a look at how marketing people see the customer. This is the old way of defining the customer journey. It worked for years. It's sort of a passive way of looking at the customer, very simplistic, kind of linear, if you will. And then around 2006, a bunch of advertising people got together at what they call the ARF, which is the Advertising Research Foundation, and they came up with this new way of describing the customer journey, which was full of emotion, almost religious fervor. Look at those words, conversion, loyalty. I mean, it's incredible. It's an advocacy, especially. So what did UXers do? They responded by saying, okay, we can do this thing called persuasive design. We can build persuasion into our design. But the question is, are you really creating an emotional connection with customers, not just users? And UX and designers also learn how to build trust into interfaces. So, but the recent surveys show that 60 to 80% of defectors of a brand were satisfied or very satisfied with the previous brand. So maybe trust really isn't as influential as we think. So what did marketers do? They upped the ante. They said, okay, we're going to take one question and we're going to base everything on this one question, and you guys are going to have to deliver against that. I call it the Beyonce score. I mean, that's a lot of pressure. Come on. So basically, the new black is advocacy, as we know. And why is this score so popular? Well, Facebook, Twitter, social networking came around, and now marketers have a way to actually monitor this information. So now we have a new customer journey, and it's no longer this linear journey, if it ever was, but it's based on this constant sharing of information and kind of reloading of information by the customer. So how do you design for this new complex world? That's the question. Well, there's no question that we're going to have to get together. We're going to have to talk to each other. And marketing research is going to have to do a lot of stuff too. They're going to have to learn more about technology and how to leverage technology. And they're going to have to do more listening, more observing, not just asking questions. Okay, thank you so much.